Unshaken, the Feast Alabang District's 2018 Holy Week Recollection would like to thank the following sponsors. Gold sponsors. To Bellevue, Manila, always at home in world-class hospitality. Video Sonic, setting the stage. Stageman Sounds and Live. Thunder and Lightning. La Rose Noire. Arbitaria Construction Enterprise Incorporated. Solark Photovoltaic Systems Installation and Supply. Silver Sponsors. Leadway Cargo Logistics Incorporated. We will lead you further. Christine de Guzman. Interseed Incorporated. For making HWR 2018 possible. With your help and generosity, we will forever be unshaken.
Ito na ang pinakaiintay nating speaker every year at the Holy Week Recollection. Right? I think for the past 8 years that we've been doing this, at least every year, or if not almost every year, he's been with us. He's very close to our hearts. In fact, he officiated my wedding and other weddings in the Feast Alabang District. And he hails from the Diocese of Paranaque. You're going to be blessed today. Hold on to your seats. God is going to speak powerfully into your heart today. Please welcome Father Rap Rap Del Rosario.
Good morning. Today is Black Saturday. Our Lord died for our sins. May I ask you to kindly stand and give honor to our dead Christ. Kindly bow your heads and in honoring God, this God made man who saved us from our sins and took upon himself the death that was supposedly ours. We give glory and honor to our God. Lord Jesus, you died for our sins. Thank you, Jesus. You died for our offenses. We love you, Jesus. You died so that we no longer taste death. Thank you, Jesus. Today we commemorate your dying, your descending to the dead. Help us to die to our sins in honor of your great love. We express our love. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Maraming salamat po. We love you, Jesus. We love you, Jesus. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Good morning to all of you. Magandang umaga po. Palakpakan ng malakas. Kunyari, masaya kayo. Lalalala. Uupo na po yung may mauupuan. Magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat. It is so nice to be back. Today is Black Saturday. I was with you last Black Saturday. And I would like to thank you and the organizers and our church leaders here in the feast. Thank you for always inviting me. I do not presume anything. I do not lay claim on anything on being invited yearly. Hindi po ako assumptionista. Ayoko mag-assume, pero thank you very much for inviting me every year. Hindi naman ako umaasang may invite next year, pero kawalan niyo po iyan pag hindi ako na-invite next year. Palakpakan ng malakas, kunyari mahal niyo ako. Ay, nako. You all got shook. Pero ang topic ko ngayong umaga is about our being shook. You know that term shook? It's a millennial term. I was trying to Google it. There is no specific definition for the word shook. Para kang na-shaken, para kang nangatal, nanginig. You were shaken to pieces. At na-surprise ka. That's the, sabihin natin, millennial term for the description, or sabihin natin, a description of a feeling of being shaken. And you know what happened in the first Paschal mystery? When the Lord suffered, when the Lord died, He descended to the dead, and now He will raise up together with us. In that way, the Lord shook our universe. Because of the accompanying signs that we can see nung Paschal mystery, there were three accompanying signs that were given to us by the gospel writers according to them about the death of Christ. And what are those? First, sabi ng Gospel of St. Mark, at midday there was darkness. Which is kind of unusual. Kasi pagka midday, dapat tirik ang araw. And yet, the gospel writer reminds us that on that day, darkness befell upon the world. It's like a revolution. Sabihin natin, it's a reconstruction of reality. Hindi naman usual, and yet it happened. Secondly, the gospel also tells us that upon the dying of Jesus, there was a great earthquake that happened or that transpired. Lumindol. It's as if the world was being shaken because the Son of God died at 3 p.m. on Good Friday. And finally, one more accompanying sign of the dying of the Lord, the gospel writer tells us na in the temple, napunit daw yung veil that separates the sanctuary and the people. You know what these signs tell us? These are moments of shock na parang ginugulo ni Lord yung order because the old order has to pass and a new order made by God has to come. Parang sinasabi ng Panginoon, tapos na yung era ng mga tao. Panahon na ng gawa ng Diyos, and He will try to revolutionize everything. That's why the Lord tells us, I make all things new. Ganda-ganda niyan. I make all things new. Pinagpapanibago ni Lord lahat. And we have to believe that. We have to believe that. Every time we celebrate the Paschal mystery, it is a moment in which we get to realize that there is nothing in the world that remained the same when the Lord Jesus died for our sins. The sinful man becomes redeemed by grace. The fallen world becomes redeemed by grace. Nothing in us remained the same because we have been saved by God. Sabihin nyo ngayon, I am saved by God. With conviction, I am saved by God. Tingin ka sa katabi mo, tanungin mo, sigurado ka? Ayan. It's a new order. Parang binabaligtad ni Lord yung ating mundo. Yung dating marumi, napapalinis niya. Yung dating makasalanan, napapatawad niya. Yung dating tayo dapat ang mamamatay, siya na yung kumuha ng kamatayan. The old order has passed because the death of Christ brought all things new. And that is why it is the fulfillment of the Lucan Gospel prophecy in which the Lord Himself said, I have come to bring fire into the earth, and how I wish that fire was already kindled. Pinagpapanibago tayo. Parang binabaligtad yung mundo natin. Yung akala nating tayo has been redeemed into a better plane. One time, nagdadasal po ako sa isang simbahan. Lenten season din nun. Habang ako'y nagdadasal, I was alone. I was there kneeling down. An old lady stepped into the church and began to pray the Stations of the Cross. Have you prayed your Stations of the Cross this Lent? Nakapagdasal na ba kayo? Huh? Totoo. Tumingin kayo sa mga mata ko. Yung walang kasinungalinga. Ha? May nagdasal ng Stations of the Cross na matandang babae. Ang problema, she began from the 14th station. Nagsimula sa 14th station. Nagtaka ako, tinitignan ko, bakit 14? Baka nagkamali lang. Maya-maya, pumunta sa 13th station, sa 12th station, 11th station, lumipat maya-maya, 7th, 6th, 5th, 4th, 3, 2, 1, and she prayed the closing prayer, kneeling down beside me. Hindi ako nakatiis. Sabi ko, na-admire naman ako sa piety mo kahit dadalawa tayo dito. Nagpe-pray tayong dalawa. I just have a question to you, Lola. Bakit naman baligtad yung stations mo? Sa 14 ka nagsimula, sa number 1 ka nagtapos. Sabi ni Lola, naku, Father, kaya naman pala ganun, baligtad pala. Kaya pala, imbis na pahina ng pahina, palakas ng palakas ang Panginoon. Kaya pala, imbis na nahuhubaran, padamit ang Panginoon. Imbis na nasusugatan, pakinis ng pakinis ang Panginoon. It's the same thing. Binaligtad niya, trip niya doon, bahala ka sa buhay mo. But you see, my point here is this. My central thesis to you this morning would be this. The only way by which we can approach our God and do His will is for sometimes to be shook from our old ways so that we may rest secured in Him. Uulitin ko lang. You see, in Christian life, it is rather imperative that we become discerners of the hand of God leading us. Sometimes in life, may mga pagkakataong yayanigin tayo ng Diyos so that we may get to understand that after the trouble, after the tempest, there is rest secured in His faithfulness and love. You will be shaken. Totoo yan. No one is spared from suffering. Pero after your shaking comes your own restoration because we stand on the solid ground of the love and mercy of God. Yan ang good news ngayong umaga. Palakpakan natin si Lord. I got this one moment of my being shook. I was invited to celebrate a mass sa Iba, Zambales by a priest na itago na lang natin sa pangalang Father Arwin Isonza. Yun talaga yung pangalan niya. The mass is at 5 p.m. And so I left Las Piñas sa parish na mga around 8 a.m. Plenty of time. Kaya lang I allotted 3 hours of forever sa EDSA kasi dadaan ako ng EDSA. Ang lupit ng EDSA, no? May forever talaga. Oo, totoo yan. Kung nanliligaw ka, lalaki ka, yung nililigawan mo, dalin mo sa EDSA. Nanliligaw ka, nasa EDSA kayo. Sinagot ka, nasa EDSA pa rin kayo. Abay, nag-aaway na kayo, nasa EDSA pa rin kayo. Nag-uusap na kayo ng kasal, nasa EDSA pa rin kayo. Ganyang kalupit ang EDSA. Nag-alat ako ng 3 hours sa EDSA. I was driving. And when I drive alone. It's my stress fest na sabihin natin, pang stress free ko ito eh. I really like driving, especially when I'm alone. And if I drive, I usually sing along. Oh, totoo yan. If I drive, I usually sing along. Nandun na ako sa NLEX, and then I went na sa SCTEX. It was about noon time. Sobrang init, I must understand. At habang nagda-drive po ako, I was singing along the song of Mariah Carey, We Belong Together. Talaga naman. Oh, kumakanta talaga, bumibirit ako. Who's on Magdalene, knowing times get rough? Who's gonna talk to me in the bond of the sun comes up? Who's gonna gumaganyan talaga ako. And when I was about to conclude it, We Belong Together, sumabog yung gulong ko sa likuran. And I was like, da! A truck passed me by, and I just alighted, or I just passed by a bridge na sobrang taas. I could not control the SUV. I wiggled to the right, I wiggled to the left, and I forgot the lyrics of the song. Oo, try mong maganon, sige, kung di ka makakanta, para kayong sira. E ginilid ko yung aking SUV, yung aking sasakyan, and there I was shaking. I could not believe what happened. You know why I was shaking? Because after na pumutok yung gulong ko and I was wiggling and I could not control seemingly my vehicle, a 10-wheeler truck passed me by and I just passed by a bridge. Eh paano kung nag-tip over ako? Nalaglag ako sa bridge. Eh sira na nga yung mukha ko, masisira pa. Wala nang tatarungan yan. Eh kung masagasaan ako ng truck, di ba? Abay, gusto ko pag namatay naman ako, titignan ako sa ataol, ay ang pogi ni Father. Di ba? Eh, paano yung pagdurog-durog na ako? Ay, giniling. Ganon. Parang, di ba? Oy, Pampangas best. Ganon. Di ba? Mahirap eh. I was shaking to my bones. I could not believe. And so, with the help of two enforcers in SCTex, I was able to change the wheel sa likuran. And I drove again, without music, going to Zambales at 20 kilometers per hour. Eh, nakakatakot eh. Nakakatroma. I went there just in time for the mass. And as I was celebrating the mass, I was really shaking. Sabi ng classmate ko, ano ba nangyari sa'yo? Sabi ko, Arwin, pakiramdam ko. Pare, parang namatay, mamamatay na yata ako. I just cheated death and I was shaking to the bones. The Lord be with you. Hindi ako makakonsentrate. I kept on reminding myself. I kept on repeating the scene in which the tire burst and I lost control. But you know what? Within that mass, I said to myself, I may be badly shaken, but I am alive. And I know that I was shaking in my core, and yet I was standing on the unshaking ground of the love and mercy of God for me. Buhay po ako, hindi po ako multo. Hawakan niyo man ako, tunay akong flesh and blood. Nanginginig man ako. Pero nakatayo ako sa hindi makapakinig na pagmamahal ng Diyos sa akin. I cheated death. Eh pero siyempre natotrauma rin naman ako. May trauma rin ako. Simula nung nangyari yun, ayokong naririnig yung kanta ni Mariah Carey, We Belong Together. Ayoko. Oo. Talaga promise. Nakakatrauma eh. Sige, patugtugin niyo pa. Oo. Yan yung kinakanta ko. Ganun ako ng ganun. Ganun ako ng ganun. Maya-maya, sumasabog na yung gulong ko. Tama na. Natotroma na ako eh. Tama na. Iwan ko kayo dito, sige. No, totoo yan. I was there standing up. You see, this holy week that we are traversing into. I think it is rather imperative also for us to see that there are times in which we will be shaken also in our faith. We will be shaken by life circumstances. May mga troubles na darating, may mga inconveniences na darating, but don't you ever worry. And every time that there will be a shaking, just hold on to God and God will fulfill His promise of unshaken love. That's the thesis that I would like to give to you this morning. And we would like to look at it from the lenses of these four images for us. Okay? Number one, let's look at Abraham's shook moment. Kilala niyo si Abraham, Father Abraham. Huh? Abraham, in the Hebraic term, means the great father. In order for you to be great, you have to have children. You know, kitang-kita natin yung buhay ni Abraham as the father that was called by God to be the father of all nations. His children will be as numerous as the stars and as plenty as the sand in the seashore. Kilala natin si Abraham. But you know what we underappreciate about Abraham? Is the fact that when he was called by God, it was his shook moment also. At 75, Abraham was called by God from his fatherland in Ur to go to a place in the land of Canaan, a place that he hasn't even been. Walang GPS nung araw. Walang Google map nung araw. And he was discerning a call that he didn't even know if it existed or he was alluding to himself only. Abraham was 75 when the Lord asked him to transfer a residence. Meron po ba dito sa ating 75 years old? Huwag po kayong mahiya. Don't shy. Don't shy. Sino po ditong 75 na? Taas po ang kamay. Please, let us recognize you. 75, mommy? 70? 77. Oh, imagine. Mommy is 77. That's more than 76, mommy. Mommy, can you please stand? May we recognize you, mommy? Palakpakan natin si mommy. Camera, please, kay mommy. Ayan. Mommy, 77 na si mommy. 75 si Abraham nung sinabi ng Diyos sa kanyang, you will transfer your household, leave your fatherland, and you will go to a land in which I will point to you. Abraham left his residence to go to a land of God-given providence at 75. Hindi biro yan. Ang maglipat ng bahay, hindi biro yan. Eh ako, I know the agony of having to transfer residence. Every after 6 years, we are moved to another parish. And I come from a parish na, sa daang hari in which people are constructing their houses. I know what it feels like to bless a home na puro kahon pa ang laman ng bahay. Bakit? Naglilipat pa. Minsan nag-bless ako ng bahay, punong-puno ng kahon yung bahay. Sabi ko, Mami, ilang linggo na po kayo dito? Ay, Father, 3 taon na ho. Pero nakakahon pa rin ang bahay. It's so nice to see people transferring residences because it is inconvenient. And you know what I like most if I bless houses? The food after. The food that is served thereafter. Totoo yan. Pag naghanda yung mga parishioners ng pagkain, kasi may house blessing, wagas. May pa-take out pa. Isang linggong budget ng kumbento, kayang i-cover. Nag-bless ako ng bahay sa daang hari. Lilima kami. Si mami, si lola, yung kasambahay. Ako at saka si Julius, yung seminarista namin. After blessing the home, talagang minadali ko. Ang bango ng crispy pata eh. Okay. Okay, mami. Kainan na tayo. Ang ganda ng table. The table was very little lang naman, modest lang naman, but it had 2 of every kind. 2 baboy, 2 baka, 2 manok, 2 isda, 2 leche plan, 2 makapuno, 2 ube, may halo-halong 2. Lahat nag-aapawan. May isang dessert, matutumba na sa lamesa. It was all brimming with food. And I was telling mommy, mommy, tawagin niyo na po yung mga kakain. Sabi niya, ay hindi father, para sa'yo lahat yan. Naawa ako sa sarili ko, sabi ko sa kanya, ganyan po ba tingin nyo sa akin? Patay gutom po ba ako? Eh pero tinake out ko marami. O ano, akala mo hindi ko papatulan yan? Oy, tipid din sa budget yan. My point being, when Abraham was called, he was called at a very old age and he had his moment of shock. They were Bedouins. And Bedouins transfer residences one after another, but he was 75. And he had to leave the fatherland for a land that is given to him by the Lord. Niyanig ni Lord yung buhay ni Abraham. And it bode blessings for him. Let's look at Moses. Moses, he got his shook moment also. Madalas alam natin si Moses to be the man who led the Israelites out of Egypt. Nagparting of the Red Sea, nagkaroon ng 10 commandments, may daladalang tablet, ibinato and everything, you know. The story of Moses, he led the Israelites from a wandering landless desert nomads to a people with a land they can call their own for 40 long years. That was the life of Moses. They were wandering in the desert for 40 long years. Ang hindi natin na-appreciate bilang Kristiyano was the very call of Moses in front of the burning bush. And that was the moment of shock for Moses. Alam natin yung crossing of the Red Sea, alam natin yung giving of the Ten Commandments, but we fail to appreciate the magnitude of the call of Moses in front of the burning bush. Anong sabi ng Panginoon sa kanya? I am who am, and I ask you, I send you to Pharaoh so that you may free my people. Eh, sino ba si Moses nun? Moses had a wife. Moses had a family. May anak na siya noon eh. He had livestock to take care of. Ibig sabihin, mayroon siyang pamilya, mayroon siyang stability, mayroon siyang kabuhayan. And the Lord is asking him, set that aside. Set aside your convenience. Go to my people and free them from the clutches of Pharaoh. Shook yun! You will be asked to leave behind everything for a mission you don't even want. Para ano? Tumanggap ka ng tumanggap ng mga reklamo ng mga Israelita for 40 long years? And at the end of the long journey, you can't even step on Holy Land or the Promised Land because the Lord said so. That was Moses' shock. Iniwan yung pamilya for a ministry that the Lord wanted him to do. Hindi po madali iyon. Kaya nga more and more learning from the story of Moses in the Bible. Alam nyo, mas na-appreciate ko sa story of the call of Moses, yung gift naming mga pare ng celibacy. Hindi po kami nag-aasawa. Bakit? Para makafocus kami sa ministry, walang kayang kailangang iwan. Kasi mahirap yun eh. Pag pari ka, tas may pamilya ka, ang hirap no, sumain nyo ang Panginoon, maya-maya anak mo nandyan, daddy. Ang hirap nun. Pag nagkasakit ang anak mo, pagka anong may kailangan, anong sasabihin ko sa tao? Magkakaroon po tayo ng second collection para sa diaper ng aking anak. Nakakahiya! Huwag ganun! And you know what really spared us to focus on our ministry? Is that we don't have to explain to our wives. Because we don't have wives. Imagine ninyo, di ba? Saan nauubos ang oras ng mag-asawa? E di sa bangayan. Away kayo ng away. We don't have to explain ourselves. Kami ang nagsesermon, hindi kami ang sesermonan. Ah, nagtataka kayo bakit ako masaya? Siyempre, single la. But that's the point. Ito, binabasa ko yung buhay ni Moses. I get to realize how giftedness, the giftedness of celibacy. Imagine ninyo, hindi kami nagpapaliwanag. Eh, nakakapagod din magpaliwanag eh. I understand a couple, nag-aaway lagi sila because of the gambling problem of the man. Baraha ng baraha yung lalaki. Kaya binigyan siya ng ultimatum ng asawa niya. Honey, pag hindi ka nagbago, hihiwalayan kita. Itigil mo yung pagsusugal ng baraha mo or I will leave you and I will separate from you. Nagbago yung lalaki. After 2 weeks, yakap-yakap ng lalaki ang kanyang misis sa kama. Gulat na gulat si misis dahil ang kamay na nakayakap sa kanya may baraha na hawak. Galit na galit si misis. Itinapo niya yung kamay at pinagalitan si mister, magpaliwanag ka. Di ba nag-quit ka na? Bakit may baraha ka na naman? Iiwan na kita! Sabi ng asawa niya, sandali, magpapaliwanag ako. This is not what you think it is. It is my religious vocation now. Anong religious vocation? Siyempre, sabi nung kanyang asawa, pag nakakakita ko ng baraha, I am reminded of the story of the Bible. A is for one, because I worship the one God. 2 is for the 2 greatest commandments, to love God and to love your neighbor. 3 is for the Holy Trinity, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. 4 is for the 4 evangelists, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. 5, what are the 5 numbers for? For the 5 loaves and 2 fish, to remind me of the providence of God in our family. 6, the 6 water jars that the Lord converted from water into wine, so that I may relish with you the marriage sacrament I said yes to the Lord with you. 7, the 7 capital sins and the 7 cardinal virtues. 8, 8 Beatitudes to remind me of how good it is to rejoice at the blessing of the Lord kahit walang-wala na tayo. 9 reminds me of gratitude because there were 9 persons who never said thank you to the Lord after they were cured of their leprosy. 10, kailangan pa bang i-memorize yan? Eh, the 10 commandments. Sandali, hindi tayo tapos. Jack, J reminds me of my God and Jesus, my Lord. Q stands for the Queen, who is Mother Mary. And K stands for you. Bakit kasi ka, kakainis ka na eh. Imagine ninyo, kung may asawa kami, edi anong ginawa namin? Paliwanag lang ng paliwanag. That's why you have to understand the conundrum of Moses. Iiwan niya yung pamilya niya for a ministry, and that was his moment of shock. Look at Joshua. Joshua took over the leadership from Moses. And Joshua, having to be the young one, the strong one, the motivated one, Joshua had to be shocked from his understanding of strength so that he may not depend on himself, but he may depend on God alone. Kailangang maunawaan ni Joshua na yung leadership niya will stand and fall on God and God alone, not on his own youthfulness. Hindi sa dahil ganado siya, hindi sa dahil malakas siya, mahina na si Moses. Joshua had to learn to be shocked in his understanding of strength. Look at what happened to the walls of Jericho. Diba, iko-conquer nila yon, diba? Iko-conquer nila yung walls of Jericho. Eh, syempre, sabi ni Lord, I have delivered Jericho into your hands. So, ibig sabihin, ika-capture nila yung Jericho. How? Did Joshua create a military to capture and to besiege Jericho in its walled city? No. Paano iko-conquer ang Jericho? Sabi ng Panginoon, for 6 days, you will circle around Jericho, singing songs, and blowing the trumpet. Magpo-procession kayo. You will not go into the battle. You will enter into praise procession. On the 7th day, you will process 7 times around the walls of Jericho, and on the 7th round, the trumpet will be blown, and you will shout to the top of your lungs, praising God, and the walls of Jericho collapsed. Joshua had to learn that the power of God depended not on his strength, but on the strength and the might of God. Kaya Joshua was shocked kasi giniba ng Panginoon ang kanyang pride and arrogance. Eh, pero may scientific explanation yun. Alam nyo ba't bakit nagiba yung wall? Kasi diba, may battle. Eh, nung magbabattle na, aba, ang mga Israelita, nagprosesyon. Anong ginagawa natin pag nagpo-prosesyon? Hindi ba nanonood tayo? So, all the people came watching the procession. On the 7th day, the people came watching, and then, the Israelites were circling Jericho. At pagkatapos nung nagsigawan sila, and the walls came crumbling down. Bakit? Lahat ng mga nang-usyoso na mga taga-Jericho nasa gilid ng pader, hindi kinaya ng pader ang weight, gumiba ang pader nang sumigaw sila dahil sa vibration. Yun ang scientific explanation doon. Kaya ganun talaga. Pag may nang-usyoso sa buhay nyo, hayaan mo lang kasi magigibai yan. Babagsak yan sa sarili niyang chismis. Pweh! No, that's a scientific explanation for that, no? That's Joshua. Joshua. 4th, we look at St. Peter. And St. Peter had the greatest shock of all. Bakit? Because St. Peter was a little stubborn. He would not accept the love of God and Jesus as the divine love entering to him. Si St. Peter, ang dami niyang categories, no? Kasi ang categories ng pagmamahal niya, human love. Ang categories ng kanyang service, it's human service. Lord, shall I forgive my brother 7 times? And then the Lord was telling him, hindi. Not 7 times, but 77 times 7 times. Not 1 glass, but 28 glasses ng gatas ng choco. Ganun. Oh. Laging may frame si St. Peter, no? Laging may frame. Totoo yan. Sabi, nag-transfiguration, Lord, it is so good to be here. Dito na lang tayo. Let us pitch 3 tents here in Mount Tabor. Sabi ni Lord, no. We go down. The Son of Man will suffer. Tapos sabi ni Lord sa kanya, and who do you say that I am? You are the Messiah. And I should suffer. Sabi ni St. Peter, hindi. Nasa frame pa rin ng human service. You will not suffer. Sabi ng Panginoon sa kanya, get behind me, Satan. Lagi siyang nakakulong sa kanyang biases of human dynamics. Look at what happened in the washing of the feet, which I hope your parish priest did. Sa parokya ko, naku, dati talagang nagwa-washing of the feet kaming mga pare. Hinuhugasan namin yung paa at hinahalikan namin as a sign of humility and putting on the clothes of Christ. Kaya ang bilin ko sa mga apostoles ko lagi, hahalikan ko lang ang mga paa nyo pag nagpa-poots pa kayo. Pagka marumi yan, flying kiss lang yan. Gana. Sabi ng Panginoon, buhugasan ng Panginoon si St. Peter. And what did St. Peter told the Lord? You will not wash my feet. Ayaw. Bakit? Ang concept of love ni Peter, give and take. You give, I receive. I give you, I take something for you, from you. Laging human frame. You will not wash my feet. He would not allow that unconditional love be received by him. Ayaw niya. Kasi divine frame yun eh. Kaya sabi niya, you will not wash my feet. Sabi ng Panginoon sa kanya, if I don't wash your feet, you will have no inheritance with me. Natakot ang Pedro, wala daw mamanahin. Kaya sabi niya, then wash my body as well. Sabi ng Panginoon, tapos ang tubig, hindi ako nakapag-igib. Walang ganon. Only the feet has to be washed. Kaya nga, even if Peter denied Jesus 3 times, the Lord asked Peter in John chapter 21, do you love me? Yes, Lord, I love you. Do you love me? Yes, Lord, I love you. Do you love me? Kasi ganun ang love of God. Gigibain ng Diyos, the Lord will shake our parameters of love because His love will always be unconditional. The Lord loves us no matter what. No ifs, no buts. Basta mahalang tayo ng Diyos, we are ready to receive that. Period. No return. No exchange. Ganun ang love of God. Walang conditions. Basta mahal ka lang, iyon ka. At kailangang basagin ni Lord yung concept natin ng pagmamahal. Hindi kailangan ng kapalit. Wala tayong kailangang gawin. It is pure and unadulterated love. No more, no less. One time, nasa South Supermarket po ako, bumibili ako ng dog collar. Dito sa South, sa ATC. I bought a dog collar for my dog. Of course, alangan namang sakat. After me was a lola na may hawak na diaper pang bata. So I would assume the lola is buying the diaper for the apo. Kasi pang bata eh. Kung adult diaper yon sa kanya yon. Natuwa ako. I got so touched kasi yung binili kong dog collar was only 140. May sukli pa ako. And then I saw the lola carrying a diaper. I saw my mama in her. Kasi yung lolang to mayroon ng apostolic mission. May mission para sa mga apo. Apostolic. Apo. Hindi nyo alam? La? Kamusta naman ang vocabularies nyo? Bababa ng IQ. Binayaran ko. Sabi ko kay Ate Teng, ako na bahala sa diaper na binibili ni Lola. Ah, kayo na po magbabayad? Hindi, hindi. Ikaw magbabayad. Sinabi ko na nga ako, di ba? Bayaran mo, ipapachachar sa ano mo yan, sa sweldo mo. Ako na po magbabayad. Tumingin ako kay Lola, sabi ko kay Lola, Lola, akin na po yung pambayad. Ako na po magbabayad ng inyong diaper, ha? Ako na po. Sabi niya sa akin, ha? Sabi ko, opo Lola, ako na po magbabayad niyan. Ako na po, charge niyo na po sa akin. Ha, talaga? Hindi Lola, ikaw na magbayad ng dog collar ko. Sabi ko, Lola, ako na po. Sabi niya, bakit? Sabi niya, Eh, sabi ako naman, ba't ba ako tatanungin ng bakit? Unconditional love nga eh. Sabi ko lang sa kanya, Lola, birthday ko ngayon, ako ang anak ni Mayor, babayaran ko na po iyan. Sabi ko, Lola, na-touch ako sa'yo kasi may dala kang pang-apo mo. Nakita kong nanay ko sa'yo, na-touch ako na magbabayad niya. Tapos sabi niya sa akin, bakit? Ano bang kailangan mo? And I was like, la, excuse me, no? Ano mang iniisip mo? Cha-chancingan kita? Excuse me! Lola, baka bumuka lupa, Lola. Pero sabi niya sa akin, ano bang kailangan mo? And sabi ko sa kanya, Lola, wala. Na-touch lang ako sa'yo. Gusto kong bayaran yung diaper na yan. Pinabayaran niya sa akin, syempre nagpasalamat siya. Abay, gusto pang kunin yung number ko, baka magpapalibre pa. Di ko nga binigay. Pero maganda yung frame ni Mami, ni Lola. Ano bang kailangan mo? Eh, nililibre na nga kita eh. Wala akong kailangan sa'yo. Ikaw ang may kailangan sa akin. Unconditional love eh. Sometimes hindi tayo makaget over dyan. Unconditional love. It is sometimes the most shaking moments of our lives in which we get to realize God loves us no matter what. God loves us no matter what because we just have to receive the love. In many ways, we are lost. We got lost. We are already lost. But God is waiting for us to come back home. Bakit? Kahit na ano pang nagawa natin, God will always be there to receive us. Babasagin niya ang trip natin, especially if we are putting Him into the frame. Kaya nalulungkot ako bilang pari pagka may lalapit sa akin, Father, pakiramdam ko yung kasalanan ko, hindi mapapatawad ng Diyos. Titignan ko ng malupit yan. Bakit? Ikaw ba ang Holy Spirit? Hindi ikaw ang Holy Spirit. You do not determine what God can or cannot forgive. Basta magkumpisal ka, akong bahala sa penance mo. At ako, magmagaan ako magbigay ng penance. One Our Father, three Hail Marys, and one Glory Be. Tapos ang usapan kahit gano'ng kalaki yan. Pero pag nabwisit ako sa'yo, lalagyan ko ng Stations of the Cross in between yan. Para magtinutino ka, huwag kang lumapit-lapit sa akin, mabwisit mo pa ako. Allow God therefore to shake you. There will be times we will be shaken of life circumstances. May mga financial difficulties, may mga relational difficulties, may mga times susubukin ka talaga, death in the family, cancer, ulcer, lahat ng sakit. There will be times you will be shaken in your faith. Pero ito lang masasabi ko, no matter what the shaking would be, stand erect. Hold on to God because God will always make a promise na hindi tayo iiwan ng Diyos. That is the good news today. No matter what the world throw at us, kahit na ano pang pagdaanan ninyo, the Lord's love will always be the solid ground on which we stand. Tatayo ka lang. Ba't ano akala nyo sa akin ngayon? Wala akong pinagdadaanan. Marami akong crisis sa buhay. Marami akong pinagdadaanan. Pero halata nyo ba? Wala lang, chill lang ako. Cute lang ako. Pero marami akong pinagdadaanan. Ganun talaga. Bakit sino bang walang pinagdadaanan? Sino ditong perpekto? Sino? Adi kayo na ipapako ko sa Panginoong Cruz. Kayo na. The point is this. Be shaken if God permits so. Pagdaanan mo. But don't lose hope because God will always be a constant, a ground on which we stand. So just like the resurrection, we stand erect and face the east because we are children of the Easter morning. We will be there. God will always be here and God will always profess His undying love for us. Kaya nga siya namatay sa krus eh. Because there is nothing in this world that can separate us from the love and mercy of God. Palakpakan natin si Lord. There is this beautiful song I really, really, really like. No? Yung song na I Will Be Here. Pwede akong uminom? Oh, for our ending, I'd like us to reflect on this song and realize na no matter what happens in our lives, God will always be the constant who will say to you, andito lang ako, anak. Don't worry, anak, andito lang ako. Because I will always be here for you. Let me sing to you the song. No? If you know the song, if you know the song, shut up, let me sing the song. Bakit ako, akong speaker? Kayo ba na-invite? La? Moment ko to, agawin. No, you can sing along.
Tomorrow morning, if you wake up and the sun does not appear, I will be here. If in the dark you lose sight of love, hold my hand, have no fear, 'cause I will be here. I will be here when you feel like being quiet, when you need to speak your mind, I will listen. And I will be here when the laughter turns to cry, through the winning and losing and trying, we'll be together. 'Cause I will be here. Tomorrow morning, if you wake up and the future is unclear, 'cause I'll be here. Just as sure as seasons are made for change, our lifetimes are made for years, 'cause I will be here. I will be here. You can cry on my shoulder when the mirror tells us we're older. I will hold you and I will be here to watch you grow in beauty and tell you all the things you are to me. I will be here.
Will always be here for us. He will never abandon. And that's our prayer also. That even if in life we encounter problems, difficulties, it's like we're being buried into the mud deep of life's tempest, sige lang. Just proceed. Because the Lord will always sing to us, I will be here. May I ask you to kindly please stand? And And we offer this prayer to our Lord. Our Lord Jesus Christ, you suffered, you died, and on the third day you will be raised. Bring us with you in your resurrection. Allow us to share in the light of your grace. Keep us into your heart. We offer you, Lord, our sufferings, our trials, our tragedies and our failures. Lord, they are all yours. And as much as you were buried on Black Saturday and you hope for the resurrection on Easter Sunday, allow us to rise with you, my God. Isama mo kami sa pagbangon mo muli. All our trials we will leave behind. Our problems we will transcend. Our life we will offer to you. Because you, my God, have risen from the dead, and you will take us with you. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Happy Easter to all of you. Maraming salamat po. Thank you. We love you. God loves you.
Let's give the Lord a big hand for Father Rap Rap.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Father.
Sige po, thank you. Uwi na ako. Bye-bye. Mahalang bayad sa akin.
Let's give the Lord a big hand for that powerful message. Can you just tell the person beside you, allow God to shake you. And dear friends, as we allow God to shake us, I ask you that you continuously hold on to the rock. For when we hold on to the rock that doesn't move, that is constant, we will continue to be unshaken. As we stand on solid ground today, let us pray and thank God for everything that had happened for the past 3 days. I invite you now in prayer. Father in heaven, you who have begun the good work in us will complete it in Christ Jesus. You are the cause, the reason why we are all here. And as we heard your word from start up to the third day of our resurrection, we know, Lord, that we will carry in our hearts your word that is unfailing. And so today, Lord, we know that whatever life throws at us, we will remain unshaken if we put our hope and our trust in you. This is our prayer in Jesus' name.
You'll finish what you've begun, forever strong in your love. Your name is sure, and you will fight for us, our hope forever secure. In you alone.
Come on, just your voice.
What you've begun, forever strong in you.
friends, I invite you to sit down as I introduce to you a very powerful sharer who will share her life testimony on how God has remained unshaken in His love and His constancy in the life of this person. This person is a friend of mine and a co-servant at Feast SM Bikutan. She is our care pillar head, one of my co-leaders there. And she is also the head of our social media and graphic design ministry here for our Holy Week Recollection. So yung pong mga nakikita yung poster ng Unshaken and the live stream that we have, she is the head behind those wonderful artworks. So today, my dear friends, a powerful servant and a very faithful one, let us all welcome Gladys Lacorte.
Good afternoon. Thank you, Ate Lyra. Wonderful introduction. Hello. My name is Gladys Lacorte. As Ate Lyra mentioned, I serve as a call pillar of Feast SM Bikutan. I am 31 years old po, and I know hindi halata. Madami pang baby fats. I am the firstborn of 3 children. And yes, ako po yung mukhang bunso. Before I continue with my testimony, I'd just like to say that dreams do come true. Years ago, I think 4 years ago, I was right there, I think, sa pinakalikod, seated on the floor. And it was the first time I attended this Holy Week recollection. And I thought, how awesome would it be if one day I would stand in that stage and glorify the Lord with my story. But back then, this wasn't my story. I forgot about that dream and just remembered it 2 weeks ago when I got a call asking me to share my story here today. Tama nga po sila. The dreams that we have in our hearts, God placed it there for a reason. And this is my reason. I'm here today to share my life's shakiest moments. As far as I can remember, I always had headaches. Back then, I was in high school, I called it migraines. Pagkapagod ako, kapag ka po kulang sa tulog, kapag ka sobra sa tulog, kapag ka mainit, kapag ka umuulan, kapag ka bigla ang lumamig, laging masakit ang ulo ko. Pero tuloy pa rin po ang buhay. I graduated with a degree in nursing in 2008. And in a few months, I flew to the US and started working there. In 2012, after 4 years, I came back home, down and defeated. And then, me and my family learned about the feast in PICC and we started attending. Now it's known as the Feast Bay Area. 2013, Feast SM Bikutan opened and I started serving as a writer there. Life went on. And it was really nice. But one thing stayed. My headaches. In 2014, I was feeling renewed, rejuvenated. I was blessed by the feast. And my weekly attendance gave me this new hope. And I planned to go back to the U.S. and restart my career and restart my life. But little did I know that God had a different plan for me. My headaches became worse and worse and worse each day. I was in excruciating pain every single day. When I was young, I don't know if the Titos and Titas remember this movie, but I saw a scene from a Christopher De Leon movie. He had a brain tumor. And he was crying on the floor, bumping his head into the wall. It's true that they say that when you're in pain, you just want to mask it with another pain. So nagigets ko si Christopher De Leon. Somehow that scene sticked with me. I don't know why. But I thought that was the kind of pain that you would only see in movies. Hindi po siya makatotohanan. Bakit mo gugustuhin iumpog yung ulo mo sa pader dahil lang masakit? But that scene was no longer just in the movies. It was in real life. And it became my life. Nurse po ako by profession. And I'm stubborn when it comes to doctor checkups. Ayoko pong pupunta sa doktor. Kaya ko nang i-diagnose ang sarili ko. But at that point, nagmakaawa ako sa mommy ko. Nasamahan ako to see a neurologist. Actually, a number of neurologists. We went to St. Luke's, we went to Medical City, we went to Makati Med, we went everywhere. They did a lot of tests. And it took 2 months before I was actually diagnosed. Pseudotumor cerebri. It is a rare brain disease. My symptoms were like having a brain tumor. But really, wala pong tumor. It was only cerebrospinal fluid, or like the brain fluid sa utak ko, syempre, building up for no reason and causing that crushing pain in my brain. It is idiopathic, meaning the cause is unknown. Nahanap po yung sakit ko, pero hindi maintindihan kung bakit siya nangyayari sa akin. I was slowly going blind. My mind was slowly degenerating. And for lack of better terms, I felt like I was going dumb, nabobobo na po ako. When I first served in the feast, I served as a writer. And I was a really, really good writer. I knew that. But it came to a point when they asked me to write an article. And all I could write was a lyric of a song. Kinapi-paste ko lang po talaga siya. I started having memory loss, which actually worked out well for my boyfriend and my siblings. Kasi pag nag-aaway po kami or pag nagagalit ako, bigyan niyo lang ako 5 minutes, makakalimutan ko na. Promise. Ganun ako kabilis makalimot. And though it was a good thing, because wala akong naiipong tampo, it was a sign that my brain was degenerating. Just getting up from bed would trigger terrible headaches. Almost anything I do would trigger terrible headaches. I slept a lot. I slept so much. Kasi yun lang po yung takas ko sa sakit. My sickness is not, hindi po siya nakamamatay. But it is severely debilitating. I was still alive, yes. But for a while, I stopped living. For relief, my doctors had to do spinal taps or lumbar punctures to release the pressure off of my brain. I was in and out of the hospital. I had to check into the hospital every 2 to 3 months to have it done. I had a total of 7 spinal taps in a span of a year and a half. They would put me in general anesthesia para hindi po ako masaktan, para hindi po ako mag-flinch, para hindi ko po maramdaman. Para mapasok po nila yung malaking needle into my back to drain my brain fluids, to take the pressure off. So sobrang sanay na po namin mag-spinal tap ng mga doktor ko. Naging kaibigan ko na po sila. And sa sobrang tedious ng procedure, I would wake up from my general anesthesia with the needle still sticking out sa likod ko because it was still draining. After the procedure, I had to lay flat in bed for 8 hours. Walang unan, walang tubig, walang kahit ano. I was peeing in a diaper. I was begging for water or kahit yelo lang or kahit bulak lang na basa. It was not just a struggle for me, but it was a struggle of my whole family. It was a struggle for my boyfriend. It was a struggle for my friends. It was a struggle for everyone who had to take care of me and worry about me. It was a challenge to all of us, physically, mentally, and emotionally. But personally po, it was challenging for me spiritually. Only one out of 100,000 women have pseudotumor cerebri. And out of 100,000 women, I was the lucky one. It had no cure when I was diagnosed, and it still has no cure up to this day. But at the feast, I learned, and our builders keep telling us that with God, nothing is impossible. Yes, nothing is impossible to God. So me and my family went church hopping, praying for healing. I attended all the healing masses I could go to. I prayed for God to heal me. Kasi di ba sabi, ask and you shall receive. Ask and it will be given to you. And so I asked the Lord over and over and over and over again. But I never received the healing. Lord, para saan po ba to? Lord, papagalingin niyo pa ba ako? Habang buhay na po ba to? Ano bang lesson ang tinatry mong matutunan ko? Is this the cross that I have to carry? Pero bakit? Parang mas mabigat naman po yata kaysa sa iba. When people ask me, and paulit-ulit po itong nangyayari, if may tampo ko kay God, but I'm the servant at the feast, I'm a leader. So I say with a straight face and a smile, I would say, wala, no? Magtatampo si Lord yan eh. I would just always say, you know what? Life is just unfair. But deep in my heart, I knew that every time I said, life is unfair, I was pointing to God being so unfair to me. Masunurin po akong anak. responsable po akong kapatid. Mabuti akong kaibigan. At higit sa lahat, I serve the Lord day in and day out. So, bakit po ganito? So, ano pa to? Did God directly answer me? He did not. But somehow, something happened and He spoke to me through a Bible verse, and it was John 11:4. And it said, "This sickness will not end in death. It is for God's glory so that the Son of God may be glorified through it." Friends, one Bible verse answered all my questions. One Bible verse assured me that God already knew what He was doing even before I knew I was sick. One Bible verse made me realize that I am selfish enough to think that this is just about me, because it's not about me. It's about God, and how God is still faithful, and how God is still good, and how God is still loving despite my rare brain disease. In 2015, me and my family found a neurosurgeon from the U.S. who said yes to do the surgery here in Manila in Cardinal Santos. Like the spinal taps, this surgery was more of a relief than a cure. But it could really ease the pain. The surgery cost more than 500,000. 500,000 pesos that we did not have. But with God's grace, through the loving hearts of my family, my friends, who journey with me, we got the funds we needed for it. My feast, SMB Kutan family, were huge instruments to God's blessing. I could not forget that one day when I was in the hospital, they visited me, my co-leaders in Feast SMB Kutan, and they handed me a brown envelope na kumakalansing. Puro po barya. Because even the youth in our feast donated what they had para makatulong sa akin. We were not asking for help. We were just asking for prayers. But if that's not God's faithfulness and love through my family, my friends, and my Feast Bikutan family, I don't know what else to call it. My family got even closer because of this illness. Our faith even stronger. God has blessed me with a wonderful boyfriend who was willing to journey with me through this illness. And since I cannot work regularly with the headaches, I found my true passion in graphic design, in the arts, in calligraphy, and actually in social media managing, or should I say marketing. And I was so good. And it actually led me to landing a job right now that I really, really love, which I can choose to work from home or work in the office or work wherever. And most of all, despite everything, I have been continuously serving the Lord through our feast for 5 straight years now. Today, friends, it's a little better than yesterday. No, I am not pain-free. Not right now. And I may never be pain-free. But today I stand in front of you, glorifying the Lord, not just because John 11:4 said so, but because despite of my illness, hindi po niya ako pinabayaan. So what if this is a lifetime? So what if there is no cure? So what if I will never be pain-free? No matter what happens, gumaling man ako o hindi, I will still serve the Lord. And I will still praise Him. My life goes on.
because our God goes on, and I will never be shaken because our God is unshaken. Thank you, Paul.
Let's give the Lord a big hand for Gladys Lacorte. Thank you, Jesus. Dear friends, may I invite you to stand up as we respond one last time to God's unshakable love in this place. Whatever condition, whatever situation you are in right now, I just want you to lift up your hands like this if this is a comfortable position for you. And just surrender to God whatever it is you're going through, whatever it is that you are, that life is shaking you at the moment. Just present to God in the stillness of your hearts as we all anchor on Him, the solid rock. Jesus, we stand on your word and your promise. For we know, Lord, that you always hold us in the palm of your hand, and in you we will never fall. And every time we fall, we know that we will rise up again the way that you have risen up on the third day. So today, Lord, we stand firm, anchored in our faith with courage in your victory. This is what we're holding on to today. This we declare in your name.
Oh,
Christ be our rock from now and today and here on. So tell the person beside you, may Christ be your solid rock. Let us continue to worship our God as we build our life upon Him. God is in our midst, yesterday, today, and forever. In every season of our life, He has been there. So today, let us offer our entire life to God today. Every moment, every breath that we take, let's build our life upon Him.
A sign of our surrender to the Lord. You may use the light of your cell phone to symbolize the different issues we have, our hurt. Don't bring it out yet. mamaya, isa-isa, naalala niyo yung papel na sinulat niyo tapos hinulog niyo sa mga kahon na nakasulat, hurt, death, sin. We are going to lift it, each of it, to the Lord. At pag tinaas yan, itaas niyo rin yung ilaw ng cellphone niyo. If that is also the prayer for you. And let us do this as a sign of our surrender to Jesus. Let us surrender all these things at the foot of the cross.
For those of you who have gone through debt or are going through debt right now, or you're going through some financial difficulty, can I invite you to raise your light up to God as a sign that you're surrendering this struggle up to Him. Heavenly Father, we surrender to You our difficulty in our finances, in our business, in our career. You know well our needs, and we know, God, that You are the provider of all needs. So we surrender them all to You, Jesus. We ask that You would pour out Your grace, Your abundance, Your favor, and Your power over our lives, over these needs, Lord God. We know that You can supply them and exceed them, Jesus. We ask You that You would just pour out a tidal wave, an abundance of Your blessing, Father, that we will be able to provide well for our families, grow in our careers, prosper in our businesses, so that ultimately we will be able to glorify and honor You with our lives. For this is what we believe is the ultimate purpose of our wealth, to honor You and to bless others. Bless us, Lord God. Exceed every need that we have and make our dreams come true. In Jesus' name, amen.
For those who are suffering sickness today, or maybe a loved one is sick, raise your light as a sign of your surrender to Jesus. And allow me to pray for you. Lord, You said in Your words that to those who believe in You, they can heal sickness. That's why this morning we surrender to You all the sickness in our body. Those people who are sick this morning, I pray, Father, that You touch that part of their body and heal them. Father, You are the God who heals. You are the God who restores. That's why this morning we pray that You restore us to good health. That You restore all the cells in our body that is causing our sickness. And we pray healing. We pray miracles today. And we pray, Father, that You use all the medicines, whether it's Western or Eastern medicine, use all this to heal us today. We surrender the sickness to You, Father. And we pray that as You heal us, use this miracle so that the people around us will know of Your power, will know of Your love. And we pray this in Jesus' name, amen. You can put out your light.
I invite now every person in this place who are experiencing hurt, please raise your lights as I pray for you. Father in heaven, I lift up to You every person in this place who are experiencing deep pain, trauma, or anger in their lives. We know, Lord, that You are the God of restoration. And Lord, every relationship that was severed, we pray, O Lord, that You restore them. And we know, Lord, that You are the God of mercy, forgiveness, and love. We pray that You give us the grace to let go, give us the grace to forgive, and to be merciful just like You. And Lord, we believe that as we surrender this at the foot of Your cross, healing will completely happen. and trade it with the peace that can only come from you. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Brothers and sisters, all those who have been affected or even crippled by fear, raise your lights to the Lord and allow me now to pray for you. Father, you have said to us many times, in fact 365 times in the Bible, do not be afraid. And so with courage we come to you now, our Lord, this day before Easter. We pray now that you will vanquish all our fears. We surrender to you now, and we pray that the spirit of power come upon us, because you did not give us a spirit of fear, but that of power. You said that we are more than conquerors in Christ Jesus. And so right now, as we anticipate the resurrection, not even death can make us afraid. Bless us now with your spirit and renew courage within us. And by your love that dispels all fear, destroy all fear in our lives. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen and amen.
For all of us who are sinners, who sin against God and against others, against ourselves, lift up your light. Father, we pray that our guilt will not stop us from going back to your embrace. We ask for your mercy. We ask for forgiveness. May we repair what we have done wrong. May we go back to your embrace. Fill us with love so that we will sin less every day. This is our prayer. We claim through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
I will.
God loves you and has chosen you to be His own people.
God saved you, called you, not because you deserve it, but because that was His plan from the beginning of time.
You are being changed into His image.
This means that anyone who belongs to Christ has become a new person. The old has gone and the new has come.
You are a new creation. You are forgiven of all your sins. You are redeemed from the curse of the law. You are blessed. You are the strong in the Lord. You are healed by His has the final word.
Amen.
Amen.
Jesus. Can you tap people around you, embrace them, and tell them Jesus has the final word? Be seated, brothers and sisters. And I want you to look at the screen, not us. Re-experience again our 3 days. Watch the screen, watch this video, same day. Edit.
Nakinig ka sa Kanya, pag sumusunod ka sa Kanya, pag naniniwala ka sa pagmamahal niya, pagpapalain ng Diyos ang buhay. Amen.
Dating handaan, hindi na kayo kailangang pumatok. Bukas na agad ang pintuan, palapit pa lang kayo doon. At naghihintay ang salubong, ang Panginoong Hesus Kristo.
We sacrifice, we give up, we give to another what we have received. That's love.
You don't need to do it alone. You don't need to do it alone. You don't need to do it
No ifs, no buts, not your past, not even your present, not your dark, to be nothing past, not your skeletons in your cross. And the Lord loves us, it's Holy Spirit. I love you, faith. Ayaw mo pang gabi niya?
Alabon District's Holy Week Recollection 2019.
Napansin ko kasi naiinitan kayo, kaya deep waters. Pwede ba? Let's all stand. Let us end our 3 days recollection with a prayer and a worship again. In the name of the Father, Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. We thank you, Lord, for being with us. Thank you, Mama Mary, for being with us to guide us for these 3 days. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now at the hour of our death.
Let's glorify the triune God. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Father, we pray that you lead our feet closer to you. Bring your people to the feast, to their church, to their parish, so that they can experience more of your love. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We will see you tomorrow at SMX for our grand Easter feast. And we'll see you at our own feast. God bless you and thank you so much. Happy Easter to everybody.
Come on, unshaken people of God. Let's continue to declare that He is our rock, our Redeemer, and our refuge. Come on. We all sing.
I set my feet upon the one who won't be moved. Christ has overcome. His promise is unfailing.
His love
defeats all fear. Darkness has no more. Hope fills up the night.
Oh, we all sing. Sing it out.
Nothing to fear in the battlefield. God is our hope, everlasting shield. God, we stand unshaken. Here in the world where our hope seems small, greater is He who resides in us. God, we stand unshaken. Tear down every idol. You are my confidence, rising up in me. The fight is in your hands.
Come on, lift it up.
You
say
are
that with
the
every
victory.
Voice.
Nothing to fear in the battlefield. God is our hope, everlasting shield. God, we stand unshaken. Here in the world.
sir. God bless you. Thank you so much.
For those of you who like to sign books with Brother Arun, Sister Lalaine, you will have your book signing right here on the stage. God bless you. We'll see you tomorrow.
You are like no other. you feel worthless, doesn't matter if you feel alone.